everybody. This is Natasha Wilkinson, your independent Scentsy consultant from Bathurst, New South Wales. So it is the 2nd of October, which means it's time to delve into my two full baskets of what I have been warming, what I have been using, what I have been enjoying in the Scentsy world for the month of September. So let's get started, shall we? So this video does not drag on to be a super long video. As usual, I will start off with my non-wax items. So I did change out a filter in the air purifier in the lounge room. We're now going to talk a little bit about laundry, because I do have a fair bit of laundry products in there. So I went through the laundry liquid in Frosty Air and a laundry liquid in Jammy Time. Frosty Air is new to our current spring summer catalog. If you like crisp, clean laundry scents, this scent is right up your alleyway. Jammy Time in our laundry discontinued with our last catalog. I did pick up a few of the big washer whiffs and one of the laundry liquid and some of the dry discs, because this is just, again, it's along the laundry lines. I'm not saying that because it's a laundry liquid or a laundry product, but it is a clean laundry scent, but it's got jasmine in it and it's got florals in it. So it's a sweet jasmine, lavender, not jasmine, sorry. It's a sweet lavender laundry scent, a little bit powdery, a little bit floral, but it is really soft and it is really beautiful. Then I have a bunch of dry discs that I used up. So we're coming into spring summer here in Australia. So these were used over the autumn winter period. What I tend to do is, as they start to lose scent, I just throw more into the dryer until I'm ready to take a bunch out. So these were all in the dryer, and I tend to try and do scents that are similar or complementary in case there's a little bit of a scent left. So I'm actually missing two, because over autumn winter period, before I started using the clothesline again, before the while we had the heavy frosts in the winter, I was using the dryer. But now that the frost has subsided, we're starting to get weather nice enough that I can dry my clothes on the line outside. So I did have another two, because I am missing two, because our dry discs do come in packs of two, which means my child has taken off with two of them. But they were two Fluffy Fleece, two Jammy Time, and two of the Frosty Air that I did use up in the dryer. So moving on to some light globes. So I did change out a 20 watt globe and a 10 watt globe in some of my warmers, and I have used up the Frosty Air dryer discs. So I enjoyed this. Probably not one of my favorite, the Frosty Air as such, out of all of the fragrances, but I found it to be nice and strong. It did definitely scent the clothes. Very neutral for a family if you don't want something too girly or don't want something too masculine. It's a scent that would suit a whole family, because it's just clean, crisp laundry scent, and fresh and bright. Okay, so I did pop a Peaks and Pine, one of our new Harvest or Halloween collection, which is available now, fragrance flowers in the perfume. This is a great performer in the perfume, in the fragrance flower, may I say. It's actually filtering out a little bit into my bedroom, because it is in the ensuite bathroom at the moment, and it's a very fresh, cool green tree scent. Okay, so I popped the Rum Pum Plum Scentsy Pack in the Scarecrow Scentsy Buddy that I got from the Harvest Collection. I will pop a picture of him up above here for those of you who want to see what he looks like. I have done a harvest haul and filmed it. I just haven't got to editing it and putting it here on YouTube yet. I will get around to doing that and you will see my full harvest haul and all the goodies I got from that at some stage. It's just one of my things on my list that I haven't got around to doing. So there's the rest of the Rum Plum Plum scent pack. So my poor little seashell that was attached to the handbag has had its round. Still got a little bit of scent left in it, but the charms have fallen off and I think he's been battered and I'm ready to change out the little charm clip on my handbag to something else. Haven't decided what yet. I do have a couple of charm clips. We will decide that a little bit later. So moving on to pods, shall we? So you will see again as part of my harvest haul, as my big haul, I did also pick up the new Scentsy Air, which is new to the catalog, that takes 4 pods. I will be doing a review on that whole system a little bit later. I want to spend some time with it first before I do that review, fully test it out, see what my thoughts are on it. It is a new system that takes up to 4 pods and it's supposed to scent a large area. And it is one of our new pod fan systems. So currently in it, it has going 4 maple rum cake Scentsy pods in it. They've been going for about a week in there. When I first popped these in, it filtered out. I've got them in my office little living room area. It filtered out of that little living room area. And I've still got to do a warmer tour to show you the set out of the new house, even though we've been in here almost a year now. So it's not quite new anymore. But it actually filtered out into the bigger living room area and you could smell it. It's now, after a week of going, more contained. You can still smell it, but not in the big living room area. It's now more contained in that smaller living room area, but it's still really filling up that space nicely. And these have been going for about a week in there. I did switch out By the Sea scent pods in the wall fan diffuser. These were in the laundry. I can't remember what I switched them out for. I don't have the empty container in here. Maybe I haven't gone around to putting something new in yet. Maybe I still need to put something new in. I'll have to have a look into that. And I did switch out Polar Bear Hug in my air purifier in my bedroom. It's currently got 2 jammy pine pods going. My mum, when she had her cattery, she had some of our Scentsy Goes and pods, which she's now not using anymore. So she gave me back what pods she had. And these were 2 that I don't know if she started to use, but they didn't have the case with the rest of the pods. So I thought, well, they still had set, I would use them up. So the Jammy Time ones are currently going in the bedroom. Then I worked on some bricks. So my middle son has hit that puberty stage where he's all things smelly. He sweats a lot. He's got that boy smell and it fills up his room. So there was this one day where I just like, no, I need to air the place. I need that room to smell fresh and clean. What can I use? So I did use some of my brick of cucumber and cactus water. This is just a fresh, sweet, clean, green scent. And it did the job of what I wanted. This was from a previous summer collection and then it came out as part of the summer brick. So I've got this and one other full brick, which is probably why I didn't put it in my club. And I'm not typically drawn to green scents, but this one I enjoy enough that if it was around, I would purchase more. I just don't necessarily know I would want to club it because it's one of those scents when I just want the house to smell summery, fresh, clean and sweet. Perfect scent for that. And then I could not resist, but from the Christmas tree collection or the Christmas brick collection, we've got two new fragrances that will be available the 10th of October. I could not resist trying some of the, as you can see, I've already gone through a few creams myself, the Butterscotch Griddle. So I will be making samples and sending out to my VIPs of this and the other brick. This was pretty. It's probably going to go into my club. I don't know that I would pick up another brick, but I would definitely put it in my club in bar size. So it's that rich, creamy butterscotch. There's almost this boozy warm note about it. And then it's got a sprinkling of candy cane in the description. And that candy cane is just a sprinkle. You can smell it, but those other scents, when it's warming, kind of take over a little bit. It just, I think, tones those other scents down from being overly rich or overly cloying and adding just a tiny bit of freshness. It doesn't come across smelling minty at all. So it is definitely just that little bit of a sprinkle. So there were my, I guess you could say, besides the bricks, non-wax items. Let's delve into the next basket, which contains my oils that I have been diffusing and my wax items. So I'm going to, I guess, put them in what is currently available, what are my Scentsy Club ones, like I did last time, and what I didn't necessarily club, but I had from collections or that are not from our region. So let's talk about my club scents, shall we? I'm still not quite ready to delve fully into spring summer yet. We're still getting a few cool days, so I'm still kind of working my way through some of my wintry scents, but then when we're getting some of those warmer days thrown in, I'm slowly transitioning out. So this month is kind of a little bit of both, I guess you could say, of spring, summer and autumn, winter. So I did do a, and these are scents that are in my club, not available anymore, but that I liked enough to put in my club and continue getting through the always get my bar perk. So I went through a bar of salted caramel toffee. This is just a ooey, gooey, rich, chewy caramel toffee. It is everything that the title says. It is beautiful. It is rich. It is decadent. It is one of those scents you have to be in the mood for, because it can come across a little bit cloying. And it's also a really great mixer. And actually what I did with this, this is what is currently in my warmers and I'm ready to change out because it's kind of lost its scent today and has been going for the last 2 days. I actually had that in warmers with, I had 2 cubes left of Johnny Appleseed, which is a scent not from our region, but is basically an apple scent. So I had that going in a mixture to kind of tone down the cloyingness that you can get with salted caramel toffee because we're coming into spring. And then because I didn't have quite enough of that, I had a little bit left of, from our last Bring Back My Bar, Juicy Apple Raspberry Mix It, which is just a fruity apple raspberry scent, and it's designed to mix it. So they were kind of going in a mixture of alternating warmers to bring in a little bit of brightness, to bring in a little bit of fruit, and to create kind of a caramel apple type vibe. So that's what I had going. Then from my club, I did use a bar of Ravenclaw Wit and Wisdom. I do believe we will be seeing this at some stage over the next few months. I can't remember the exact date when, but we will be getting a new Harry Potter warmer. And I do believe they will be bringing these scents back out of the vault. Now, I'm not typically into leathery scents, but if I were to pick a leather scent, there would be two that I would pick that I absolutely love. And that is this one and Vanilla Oud. This reminds me of a library, thick leather-bound books, before books were a thing on the internet, when, as a kid, that just smell of books, I absolutely love it. It is sweet, it is earthy, and then that vanilla just gives you this smooth sweetness. This lasts about a week in my bedrooms because that tends to be where I put it. In the open concept area, it'll probably still last a long time, but I haven't actually tested, and it would fill up an open concept area. But I don't actually really warm it in an open concept area. This is one of my favorite scents just to warm in my bedroom. And I know I don't warm it as much as I would like to, and it's because of its longevity. If I'm going to put it in its warmer, I'm going to enjoy it for all of its longevity. As I said, in my bedroom, it lasts about a week. So I want to be in the mood for it and I want to enjoy it all that week. Absolutely fantastic. Then in the open concept area, lounge room, I did go through two bars of my beloved Haunted Mansion. This is just a pumpkin spice bread. Sweet bakery goodness. Absolutely delicious. And then last, actually, I think I've got two what I would classify as Scentsy Club bars. I think this one's in my club, but I'm not 100% sure. This, my kids had going in their room. Minions Banana. It's just a banana scent, a very candy, like banana scent. Think the hard banana lollies that you get. That is what this is. But it warms really well. I can't wait to get my hands and warm up this myself in open concept areas, mixed with other fruity scents, mixed with other bakery scents. For me, I think I'm going to enjoy this as a mixer. My kids love it all by itself in their rooms, and they're the ones that have been claiming all the bars that I purchased when this was available. About a month back, month and a half back maybe, it is not available anymore, but I do have it in my club because it's one I know I will enjoy in summer. We don't get very many banana scents, and my kids are just going to reach for it all year round. This tends to be all my kids' choice of scent lately, and I have not had a chance to warm any of the bars I brought. I think I brought three or four bars when it was available, and I think this is the second bar they've gone through. It could be the first, but I have a feeling they've gone through two of the four bars I purchased already. I'm not 100% sure on that because my kids have been reaching for that scent. And then I did in my bedroom a bar of Evening Sky. So this is recently discontinued. It was new to our catalogue last season and they've discontinued it. We may see it back next season, but this is a beautiful, perfumey, florally scent. Slightly comes across a little bit vanilla-y. A little bit fresh, really enjoyable in my bedroom. So, moving on to scents that are currently available. So, all of these scents are currently available. Some are from our current Halloween collection and some are from our new catalogue. And I want to say, these are all club-worthy scents to me. While they're not in my club now, well, the Halloween ones are because they're limited time only. But while the current catalogue ones aren't in my scent now, at the end of this catalogue season, if they are to discontinue, they will be going straight into my club. So, Appleberry Shortbread. I did that in the open concept area. This is from our current Halloween collection. This is a perfect, for me, almost summer bakery. You get the rich bakery note, but then you get a really bright apple. Strong performer, open concept worthy, Lasted a full 2 days in my open concept area. I loved this enough that I put it in my club in multiples, and I will be definitely warming through a fair bit of this, particularly now as we're coming into warmer weather, and I'd probably be warming through this in summer. This is definitely a repurchase for me and definitely club worthy for me. The next one, Apple Spice Season. Again, this is from the Halloween collection. If you like apple spice scents, this is what it is. It's a really good, rich apple and spice scent. Not unique, but I love apple spice scent, so it did go in my club. Strong performer. Really good mix of the apple and spice. One didn't overtake the other. And I feel like, yes, I will definitely warm this through winter. I don't need a lot of bars, but it is in my club for the time being. I do tend to collect pumpkin spice scents, and I do tend to collect apple spice scents just so I can enjoy over winter, because we do get a lot more summery scents in our catalogue. So these are the type of scents I like in winter. So I do tend to collect them in my club so I can just enjoy them for that season round. Unlike berry apple shortbread, where I would want multiple of, I would probably only get one of these. I think my winter club's on a bi-monthly, every 2 months. I have started it off at 2. I think I've started appleberry shortbread off at 3. But I will probably downgrade in my club at some stage to 1 after I've got enough in my inventory for next winter. The next two scents are current catalogue scents. So they're not in my club yet, but if they are to take these scents out of the catalogue, they will go into my club. Vanilla Amber. So this is new, and they're both new scents to the catalogue. This is beautiful. It is borderline bakery, but not, it's in the bakery category, but you've got full bakery like vanilla bean buttercream, and then you've got your more floral, perfumey, bedroomy vanilla scents that come across, French vanilla, that have that perfumey, florally base like Simply Vanilla. This is like the two met somewhere halfway. It hasn't quite hit that very cloyingly rich bakery note, but it's still got that almost floral vanilla perfume vibe about it, but it's a little bit stronger. It's got almost a vanilla essence cooking note about this with the vanilla bourbon. Lasts longer than Simply Vanilla to me. I smell it more stronger, but it's not quite bakery, but you can see it heading towards that way. It is, to me, a very much more sophisticated version of Simply Vanilla that hasn't quite hit that bakery level, but it is so beautiful. Then I went in the open concept area, Cherry Chestnut. Absolutely love this one too. Definitely would be a club contender for me. You definitely pick up that rich nuttiness, which gives the cherry a warmth. And for me, cherry scents can go either way. I can really enjoy a cherry scent, or they can come across smelling plasticky or medicinal. And I think the chestnut scent in here added a warmth to a fruity cherry that stopped the cherry from doing that. And it was just a beautiful, warm cherry bakery. I absolutely love this. A little bit woodsy from that nutty scent, but it was absolutely beautiful. So they were the bars I got through for the month of September. And I did use 2 oils in my diffuser this month. I did cinnamon, cherry, vanilla. You can guess what scent I warmed that with. Cherry chestnut. Complemented each other so well. This is a scent I will diffuse more closer to Christmas, because it's got that very Christmassy vibe of the cinnamon, the cherry, and the vanilla. But it is absolutely fabulous, and it complemented that cherry chestnut so well. And then I had to try the new creamy vanilla nutmeg. So this is a new scent in our catalogue, and it is everything. It is rich, it is warm. This is a scent that's going to complement a lot of the type of scents I like to warm. And if this is to leave our catalogue at the end of this season, I will be stocking up on this, because unlike oils, unlike bars, there is not an always get my bar oil perk in club. So if I'm going to want more, I'm going to have to buy it at the end of the season. If they were to discontinue it by the truckload, probably won't buy it for the truckload, but I would definitely pick up probably at least two more if they were to discontinue this, because I feel like this is going to be a scent for me that I would reach for time and time again. So that was my empties. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time, stay safe and bye for now.